Hi guys, and welcome to yet another very exciting Adobe Illustrator tutorial video. In this video, we will learn how to make this cool blend text effect design in Illustrator. So let's get started. First of all, select the type tool and write your text. You can write whatever you like. I am just going to write graphic. Increase the size of the text. Make sure the text is aligned to the center of the work area. Convert the text to outline shapes. Converting text to shapes gives you more flexibility on how to manipulate it more easily. Change the fill color of the text to white. And change the stroke color to black, and also increase the stroke size. Now select your text and go to Object, and then to Envelope Distort and choose the option that says Make with Mesh. This sort of mesh grid will be applied to your shapes. If you have used the mesh tool ever, then this process is similar to it. Now for my distortion, 4 rows and 4 columns are enough, but your design might require more or less. Adjust according to your needs. Now with the help of the Direct Selection tool, select the anchor points of the second row and hold the Shift key to select the anchor points of the fourth row. Once selected, hit the left arrow on the keyboard about 4 to 5 times to introduce a subtle distortion. Do some distortion on the vertical side also. Once you are satisfied with the amount of distortion, then go to Object and expand the appearance of the mesh shape. Now select the text shape and hold the Alt key and drag to duplicate the shape. And then hit Ctrl plus D key to repeat the action. You will end up with 3 copies. Now select all the shapes and go to Object. Come down to Blend Options and click on Make. Once the blend is created, go back to Blend Effect and select Blend Options. Change the spacing to specified steps and write the number of steps that you require. I will select 11 steps, but your fonts and design might require a different number of steps. Please do experiment. Move the blend shapes to the side. Select the pen tool and draw a curved or twisted line like this in the work area. Now select both the line and the blend shapes and go to Object. Select the Replace Spline option and the Blend options. It will make a shape like this. What it does is, it wraps the blend objects around the line. You can also change the orientation of the blend shapes from bottom to top to the other way around by reversing the spline. Now we can make different sorts of design looks from it. Let's reduce the size of the object and move it to one side. Hold the Alt key and drag to make duplicate copy. Select the second copy of the shapes and go to Object, then Blend Options, and then expand the shapes. Now we will use the Pathfinder panel. By the way, if the Pathfinder panel is not visible in your workspace, then just go to Windows and select it from the drop-down menu. In the Pathfinder panel, click on this option that says Trim. Your shapes might disappear, but their stroke color is turned off, they are still there. Now I will change the stroke color to something vibrant and more easily visible. Like this dark red color. Increase the stroke size a little, and you will end up with a look like this. Now hold the Alt key and drag another copy from the original shape. Once the extra copy is made, then click the Isolate Object button. Now come down to the Layers panel and open it. Select one of the original three shapes that the blend copies are made of. Once selected, change their color. By the way, you can change their color before applying the blend effect on them, but for some unknown reason you haven't done so, then you can do it this way that I am showing. For the first, I will choose a red fill color and turn off the its stroke color. Choose different colors for the other two shapes also and turn their stroke color off also. Once done, you will end up with a beautiful blend colored effect like this. Now let me show you one more trick that you can use with this effect. Isolate the shape and change some of its colors to bring some contrast into it. With the direct selection tool, you can change the positions of the individual letters in the word. Adjust it according to your liking. I am just trying to show that it's possible. I am not aiming for refinements. And if you open up the transform panel, while the letters are selected, you can change the rest of the character properties of the alphabets also. Like rotation spacing, kerning, etc. Okay, that's it guys for this tutorial video. I hope you like it, and now can you use these techniques in your own illustrations? Please do give me feedback in the comments section about the audio quality and other stuffs. And if you have any questions about anything relating to my videos that you don't understand, also ask about it. I always answer all my questions, albeit sometimes a little late. So thanks once again for watching, and I will see you in the next video.